Bad Swishers. People, not well, not well. Somebody sit there growing rhubarb and I said, Bip.
My name is Steve Bird. I'm the past president for the last 2 years of 2009-2010 of the president of the Sun City West Agriculture Club here in the Metro Phoenix area. And we grow numerous vegetables on land that this property is a rec center property from Sun City West. It originally, the 6.5 acres was the original staging area for Del Webb to store all of his heavy equipment. So when you think that your yard is hard, try putting a steamroller, a grader, or any other heavy piece of equipment on it. We put in, there's 370 some odd gardens here that are roughly 18 by 36. This particular plot that we're in here is a what we call a double garden. This is what's left over of the broccoli. Once you take the main head of the broccoli out, you get all these nice little heads that are really good to eat. You know, this is my lunch most of the time. And we grow everything all year round. We're just getting done with our winter crops, which was our cabbage, our cauliflower, our broccoli, some of your spinaches and lettuces. And we're just starting to plant our summer crops, which are your peppers, your melons, things such as that.
Who's we? When you say we, who are the people?
We are the members. You have to be a member in Sun City West. You have to have a rec card to own a plot down here. And you don't. Our dues are only $5 a year. The rec center actually pays for our water bill. And it's very, very nominal, our cost. Now, in order to put up this large cage, it did cost me, and put in the water system, roughly $1,200.
The land itself, this is, used by the developer for what?
This is where he stored his heavy equipment, to build the roads, the sewer systems, all the rec centers. So, it was really impacted.
Well, when was construction over to where they cleared out the equipment?
We've had this property about 19 years.
And then when they had planned and allowed for people to do this, so they were willing to put in the water system and kind of gridded it out, who took responsibility for dividing it up?
The rec center said approximately how big an area would a garden be. And we said, 20 by 40, and so they said, okay, fine, we can do that, and they came down and plotted out the water system. So when you have four plots, you will have a water system that will feed off of to four different gardens at one time, and then you skip a garden and go down, and there'll be another four sets of faucets. And right now, currently, we don't pay for the water, the rec center does.
So the people have the freedom to do their own plumbing to their garden inside their area. They just get one spigot feed and then they take care of it.
What I did with mine is off the faucet, I came down with a galvanized pipe. You have to have a shutoff outside, so in case there is some problem with the water and you're not here, somebody can shut that water valve off. And every couple of weeks we have a problem with somebody's water. The timer goes bad or whatever, and you can shut the water off.
The production of food here, when you started doing this, was it more for flowers? Was it for food? Was it decorative? What was the reasoning them planting?
We are called the Agriculture Club. There is a garden club also here in Sun City West. They grow flowers and succulents and small trees and cactuses that they sell. We grow vegetables, and in our bylaws, we cannot sell our vegetables. We either give it away, in which case we give well over 2,200 pounds every year to the Westside Food Bank. The gal across the way from me is a good Catholic. She gives well over 1,000 pounds to the Catholic Church here locally every year. We have a church group in the back that grow food and give it to them, because there's some people on hard times, fresh vegetables are very expensive anymore.
That's one thing of interest to me is the production. Do you think that you're able to sustain how many people per year vegetables here? it would seem to me that one of these plots will produce more than one family could.
Oh gosh, and my wife and I are here, and I give away just hundreds of pounds of food every year. I had some eggplants that went to seed, and I had probably 30 or 40 plants, and I gave them away to everybody. But from that point in time, I gave away probably three dozen eggplant a week to my neighbors and friends.
Because we live in the Southwest here, what kind of production is there in the winter versus summer? Do you kind of cut down in the summer, or is it very productive then too?
Well, in the summer you plant a whole different crop, and like I say, we're just getting over our winter crops now. And during the summer last year, I planted two little sweet potatoes in one of the raised beds in the back there, and out of those two little sweet potatoes, I got over 50 pounds of sweet potatoes. And I still have sweet potatoes hanging in my garage, in a window in my garage. I probably grew 150 pounds of onions, of which I gave probably 50, 60 pounds away. And I still have, if they started to get old, I would take the onion, cut it up, freeze it. And I still have a number of cups of onions.
So from your experience, if a family of four, let's say, were to, two children, two adults, were to want to supply the vast majority of their vegetable intake for a year, how much space would they need?
A 20 by 40 would be plenty. Now, that you have to determine whether you want to do it in raised beds, which I do, or just open gardening. If you do it in raised beds, you'll have to have a small rodent tiller to till the soil. I've done all of mine with just a four-tine fork. I've never had a rototiller on this soil. It's the amendments that you have to add, the cow, the manure, the mulch. Every time that this, eventually when they stop producing all the little broccoli heads on it, I will chop this up and all of this will go into the ground here.
What's the advantage of doing raised beds over flat on the ground?
With raised beds, you can put more additives into it, is my feelings, and you can control it better. You can control the weeds, because now you don't have weeds growing in your aisles and everywhere else. I mean, you get a monsoon rain here, and if you're from around the world, a monsoon rain here can be 2 inches in 30 minutes, and we will have weeds growing 2 days from then. And weeds are a big problem during the summer, not so much right now. But with raised beds, the weeds don't grow into the carpeted areas, into the aisle areas, and so you really are only concerned with the bed area.
So it's more than a concern of production, it's a concern of management, having it in the raised bed.
Absolutely, it's management, and you're only watering the area that you're producing in. You're not watering areas that you're walking in.
Oh, okay.
And obviously in the Southwest, we're very concerned about water.
How much water does it take? Do you keep track of the water you use?
No. In the summertime, I will water probably every other day. During the winter right now, it is starting to get warm right now, but during the winter, maybe twice a week, sometimes only once a week. I do have a little thing that will tell me whether the ground is moist or dry or whatever.
And what enjoyment is it? It's a social aspect, not just food production.
Oh, absolutely.
Here.
You know, because what we do is, well, I go off Monday, Thursday, Friday. I hike on Tuesdays. I go fishing on about every other week. We have an RV that we go to various tours. I have a Jeep that I go jeeping with. So, I mean, I can't spend every hour down here, and I don't. I come down here, get my work done, and, you know, pick my vegetables, and you'll see a table here later that I picked today. And
well, tell me, how many hours a week do you spend on your garden on average around the year?
5-6, maybe.
And most of that's just lollygagging?
Well, you gotta go around and see. Well, the good part is, if I'm not growing it, somebody else in the garden probably is. And so, we just trade vegetables with one another, or the fellow across the way from me is a master gardener, and he grows a lot of strange plants, the kohlrabi and stuff. And
you know, one thing I did when I asked someone your experience, What has been the progression in just the last few years? How long have you been doing this?
6 years.
In 6 years, have you seen a change in the seeds, in chemicals, in knowledge, in production? What has been the changes over the last 6 years in gardening?
Well, I can tell you, you know, that mine, because my experience is that the soil, I've had so many amendments put in the last 6 years, that the volume of produce that I'm getting out of it now in comparison to 6 years ago is probably double. You know, and it's not anything, the seeds, I don't know that there are any particular difference. We do have, because we have so many gardens here, we have people that will grow a lot of the heirloom, tomatoes and vegetables. It just doesn't seem to make any sense. There's getting fewer seeds in area. You know, everybody's cutting back on what you're buying, as far as the number of seeds in a packet and whatever. It's hard. But the fellow across the way from me, that's a master gardener, gave me some green bean seeds last year, and it's called a Crockett bean, like Davy Crockett. I will probably never grow another green whole bean. The Crockett beans were so spectacularly better flavored. No string in them, just a wonderful, wonderful green bean, and very, very tolerant to diseases. And, you know, if somebody wants to know about certain things, go online and research various seeds. Go online and get your recipes. If you're overproducing so much, you know, learn how to make broccoli salad, broccoli soup, you know, the various, you know, things that are available. You know, it's not just steamed vegetable.
The popularity, is it becoming more, and is it the demographic of people participating, is it getting wider?
I think when, you know, we had the economic turndown a couple of years ago and everybody's stocks went to pot and whatever, we had probably 100 plots in the back that had not been used, not taken by any of our residents. Within the 2 years that I was president of the club, we are now sold out. Currently, there is no plots available. So we've added well over 100 members in 2 years.
How many plots are there?
There's almost 400 plots here.
Wow.
Yeah, it's a big garden. It is a production.
So a lot of people, for health reasons, I would imagine, and just to supplement their intake, they go garden.
Oh, yeah. You know, my son's stationed out at Luke Air Force Base. He's been overseas for 9 years and just got stationed at Luke. And he loves his vegetables. And needless to say, he gets carrots, he gets broccoli, he gets onions, he gets everything. My wife loves the Red Sails lettuce over here. And the spinach and the Red Sails lettuce are some of her favorites. So we have, you know, lots of good eating. The small little lettuce that you see in with the tomatoes in that front bed is volunteer lettuce that has come up for the last 3 years. It's a curly leaf lettuce like this over here, and it just comes up and goes to seed, and I let it go to seed, and it just keeps coming back and back and back.
Steve, thank you very much for spending time with us.
Well, I enjoyed it. I don't know if we'll get into growing chickens in here, but it's a thought.